Podcast Audio presents The Goose Girl by Shannon Hale.
Part 1. Crown Princess. Chapter 1. She was born Anidori-Kiladra Taliana Isili, Crown Princess of Kildenree, and she did not open her eyes for 3 days. The pacing queen directed ministers and physicians to the crib. They listened to her breathing and her hummingbird heart, felt her fierce grip and her tiny fingers, soft as salamander skin. All was sound, but her eyes did not open. For 3 days, the grave-faced attendants came and went. They prodded her, lifted her lids, slipped thick yellow syrups down her throat.
"You are a princess,"
the queen whispered to her ear.
"Open your eyes."
The baby cooed in her sleep. When the third day had worn away to the lake blue of evening, a hand parted the nursery curtains. All was still for the night. The queen dozed on the bed. The baby in her crib dreamed of milk, her round, perfect lips nursing in sleep. A woman in a fern-green robe pulled aside the curtains and tiptoed across the carpets. She slid her calloused hands under the infant's back and head, held her up, and grinned.
"Did you call me out of my house to come and tell you stories? I will, my fat one, if you will listen."
The queen awoke to the sounds of the rocking chair creaking and a voice singing about magpies and pigeons. She stood up, ready to call to the guards, then saw that it was her own sister who sang to the baby, and that the baby was looking back at her aunt with wide eyes. It was the aunt who shortened the crown princess's name to Annie. On clear days, she took Annie to the north edge of the palace grounds where no wall had been built. That far out, the garden was allowed to stray out of its ordered beds and rows and merge with the occasional copse of ash and pine. The aunt felt easier there, and she held her niece's small hand and named all she saw.
"You see the bird on the tallest branch there? The one with a yellow breast? She's migrating farther north now that the weather is warmer. The blue wing there is looking for twigs and says he has found himself a picky mate."
Annie began to speak sentences at 1 year. The aunt knew too well how Kildenreans disliked anything outside the common, and she tried to keep Annie's progress hidden. But the household staff noted it, and rumors began that perhaps the queer, green-clad Nurse Mary possessed unnatural methods of awakening a child's words. The queen was uncomfortable with the talk, and careful never to call the new Nurse Mary sister. But the king was too stubborn to worry much.
"Why shouldn't she be a quick learner? She is our daughter, as pure of blood as are ever born in this world, and has every right to speak before her time."
But the king saw little of his firstborn, and the queen even less. Caleb Longcris was born, the first son, and then Napralina Victeri, who from birth so resembled her mother that the Nurse Marys were inclined to curtsy to the crib. With the parents' attention parted, the aunt became Annie's constant companion. In cold weather or spring rain, the aunt sat on the nursery floor and told Annie stories of fantastic and faraway things. A land where mares pawed gold nuggets from the earth and chewed them in order to breathe out music. A baker who baked birds from dough and sent them out the window in search of a treasured pot of apricot preserves. A mother who loved her baby so fiercely, she put him in a tight locket around her neck so that he might never grow up. The aunt sang songs again and again until Annie learned the words, her toddler's voice as dry and delicate as a sparrow's call. A day in early summer when Annie was 5, the two companions sat in an aspen's dappled shade on the edge of the garden swan pond. Annie loved the birds that were as big as she, and begged them to eat bread out of her hands. When the bread was all gone, they shrugged their wings and skrunked at her.
"What did they say?"
They wanted to know, was there more bread for the eating, or should they go back to the pond?
Annie looked at the nearest swan straight in one eye.
No more bread. You may go.
The swan shrugged his wings again.
What does that mean?
I don't think he speaks your language, duckling.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.